believe in sharing your knowledge and sharing what it's like for you. I find most things to be a little bit of all things. Like everything's a little bit funny and a little bit sad and a little bit great. So I try to show that.
She's probably best known for her alternative hits in the early 90s.
Amazing reviews.
What have you been doing for all these years?
Abandoning the indie roots. I can feel a new expression. A lot of people feel like that's where you ought to be.
I know you don't want to alienate your fan base.
It's smart music, but she's having fun doing it.
How would you classify your music?
It's just a natural evolution.
Can an alternative girl succeed in a pop world?
And you say,
fuck it.
That's really fun.
Liz Phair, everybody.
That's it, precisely.
Please welcome Liz Phair.
Always be a boundary pusher. It's just what I do. My brand of feminism is to sort of break down walls, just kind of ram into them and like move them out of the way. I had no idea that people were going to react to Exile and Guyville the way they did. I didn't know how to make a record, so I picked like the best record I could find at the time. And I used it to help me organize my thoughts and organize my songs. And it was this great sort of ode to both girl power and classic rock and roll at the same time. These records are my diary. I always remember the making of Whip Smart. It was a hard record to make because after going through what I'd gone through on Guyville, I didn't have many songs that weren't about the industry. And I remember my manager saying, Liz, nobody wants to hear a song about the business. Like, nobody's interested in that. Like, they want to hear personal songs. But what had been so impactful for me that year was all the celebrity and the business crap, and I had very few personal songs. It's so much easier now. The business doesn't affect my writing now. Really with White Chocolate Space Egg, there's a huge shift. And that was the time of Lilith Phair when female music was having its heyday and it just felt great to be where I was at that time, making the kind of music I was making. Everything changed and it's just continued to grow from there.
So you're a single lady now?
I'm single lady.
Are you dating anybody? What's it like out there, Liz?
It's brutal. When I came out with Liz Phair, I just wanted to kick some ass. Liz Phair was another big sort of polarizing record because it was much more pop than my earlier work. And I had co-written songs with known pop producers, which really made journalists go right down the fence. I think it's really important to be authentic and to make the music that you're interested in now. Do you really know me at all? Would you take the time? One of the things about this record that would be different is a real effort on my part to convey an attitude shift that I've had as I've grown older. I have come around to a point that I'm no longer as self-conscious and I can just be the artist that I want to be. I just make the statements that I want to make and I follow my muse, and especially Everything to Me, that came out just beautifully. Girls in shortcuts, I know them well. The name of the album is Somebody's Miracle, and that came from the title track, the song Somebody's Miracle, which embodies to me that sense of holding something up in reverence that you can't have, but that shines for you, is like a beacon, is like something to move toward. I would hate to put out a record that never made you think differently and just filled up your room while you're having coffee or dinner with friends. I want to make records that you have to listen to the words. To me, that's what keeps me doing what I do. In the end, the best advice I could give to anyone going into this profession was be yourself, and that's really all I'm trying to live up to.